The BCA just concluded its investigation into a deadly police shooting that shook Minnetonka High School and tore apart a Twin Cities family. 16-year-old Archer Amorosi shot and killed by sheriff's deputies responding to a call that he was suicidal.
The story doesn't get another ending, but Archer's father is hoping that by sharing his son's story, that ending can be different for other families. He recently sat down with investigative reporter Lauren Lemanchek to talk about the missed opportunities to save his son, including a call for help the day before he died.
That's the little guy when he played baseball.
Looking at the photos, it's hard for Don Amorosi not to think of what might have been.
Archer was just about my best friend.
His son Archer, a stellar athlete, a popular kid, a beloved brother.
He could be very compassionate and was a great defender of his family and sisters.
But Archer also struggled with mental illness.
Archer had anger issues. He did, and we went in and out of therapy.
Anger that exploded in July in a confrontation at his mother's house. She called 911, and when police arrived, they say Archer refused to drop a hatchet and a handgun-style BB gun. Don watched as police fired the fatal shots.
And I've replayed what happened that day 100 times each day.
But a grieving father is trying to focus now on what he believes are the missed opportunities to save Archer's life. That's because the day before the shooting, Don Amorosi had called the Carver County Mental Health Crisis Line, saying Archer was violently punching and throwing things.
The response was, this isn't a crisis, and excuse my language, but I said, well, then what the hell is a crisis?
Then Don called 911, the transcript showing he asked officers to escort Archer to the hospital. But he also worried, telling the dispatcher, I fear that SWAT people are going to go in and kick the door down and shoot him.
The day before, that was your fear.
Somewhat prophetic, right?
Police came that day, but decided that because Archer wasn't threatening himself or others at the time, they couldn't take him in.
If Archer had been taken to the hospital that day, or if a mobile crisis team had come to your home, do you think this could have all turned out differently?
I am certain of it. I am certain of it. He'd have his shoes made with his name on them.
Now left with his son's collections, a family watch, a special holiday keepsake, a just-delivered lacrosse helmet that will never be worn, and a mission.
The only thing that keeps me going is this little crusade that I've started.
A crusade that's brought Don before the Chanhassen City Council and to the state capitol to increase resources for teens in crisis and to end the stigma around a disease that doesn't discriminate.
I don't want to see parents go through this, but I don't want to see another beautiful little boy go through this, or girl.
Lauren Lemanchek, KARE 11 News.